All right, we're going.
Yo.
Oh, you need to turn that on.
Yep. We're good. I know it's working this time, but.
Yeah, we got it down.
Oh, should I shut that door?
Yeah.
Oh, Daniel's coming. Go get it. All right, number 33, bro.
33 level of the Masons, man.
You know what's funny? Like, when Annie wears her glasses and you wear your glasses, like, you know there's people that wear glasses and they look kind of dorky, but then people that, like, it's like they look hot. Like, you look hot when you wear your
glasses.
Thank
you. I appreciate that.
You're welcome.
Feeling good.
Just spread that out.
Feeling fresh.
Start with love.
Some positivity. It's going to be a great weekend. It's been a great week.
It's been a great week. The weather has been ridiculous.
Yeah, it's been super awesome.
It's been, what, like 75 to 80, like almost every day?
Yeah, absolutely
stunning.
I think Travis
found what he's looking for. He seems happy back there.
Oh.
All right, number 33.
Oh.
Loshe apparently drank a little red wine too late last night. He's feeling a little rough. He's going to get a Big Mac afterward.
I'll feel good after the Big Mac.
What is it about? Is that like good hangover food?
For me, it's, yeah, I think it's...
Greasy?
It's not necessarily greasy. When they used to actually fry the fucking patties there, then it was greasy.
Okay.
But now they come frozen and they put them in these like microwave or these in like convection ovens.
That sounds horrible.
It's totally horrible, but fuck all. It tastes so good when I'm not feeling well.
Really? That's so weird that you would think if you feel like shit and then you go eat that, you would feel like triply like shit.
You kind of do, but then you take a nap. But I can't take a nap. I got to come to work, so I'm just going to have a Big Mac.
What time do you work?
2.
Oh. Okay.
But I've got to do some inventory stuff in a little while.
I'm
so
representing my son's school.
Yeah, Georgia Brown.
What up?
Parents drive like dumb shits.
Yes, they fucking do, man. I've started doing PSAs on our blog about like how there are people that will park facing uphill and not turn their tires.
Some people don't know that. I mean, they don't know that it's like, yo, you need to check those tires. That's what they were called.
Yep.
Chalking or checking.
Chalking is what I always heard, yeah.
And you
kick it to the curb, bitch.
Because if the car rolls, it's just going to hit the curb and stop.
Right. Apparently none of the employees know how to...
I'll be right back. I'm going to shut the door. You can talk to them.
Anyways, thanks for watching. Now you can listen on different platforms, Hyped.
I know, we're finally on SoundCloud.
And YouTube. But everybody, like all these people that I follow and listen to are all jumping off of YouTube.
A lot of them are going to other platforms.
Or they're going to their own sites. And
right. It's hard on... I'd have to look into the own site because if I know... If we could put just... Because what we could do is either start our own website, which is super easy through WordPress, or take these and put them on our 3Adventure website.
Yeah.
Either one, but...
Something.
Well, because because you know what? You know what website name isn't taken?
Dog shit, pee as fuck, cunt, motherfucker.
That's true.
I just wanted to
That's true. That's not taken. But loshelandmatt.com isn't taken either.
Okay.
I'm just saying, because nobody in the fucking world is named Loshel.
Yeah, there is. I went down
family.
To my grandmother's,
but
my
nobody in your family has a website.
There were, in the room, that on Tuesday, there was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of us, I think, who had the name
Loshel. How many was middle or first name?
All the rest except me.
Oh, okay. Got it.
I mean, I'm the third. They're all has-beens or was, never was.
Oh, wow.
No, I'm just kidding, guys. I love you.
Yeah. Well, they don't watch this shit anyway. They get enough of you.
Yeah. No, I hadn't seen him in like 9 years.
So if you guys didn't see last week, Losh let us know that his grandma had passed away. He found out on Facebook, which is kind of fucked up.
That's okay.
How was it? So you went down for the memorial?
Went down for the memorial. It was a nice drive.
And this is down in
Santa Barbara.
Santa Barbara. So like two and a half hours? 2 hours?
I stretched it out to 2.5 hours because I didn't have the registration on the back of the car.
Oh, so you were going real cautious.
I was just being cool, you know.
You better get that shit handled.
It's already handled. We're done.
Oh, good.
It's all good. Taken care of.
So was it a big gathering?
No, it wasn't big at all. And it's one of my cousins. I didn't see him there. I had another cousin who wasn't there, but then I saw her brother called her a crackhead on Facebook today.
What?
I don't think they get along.
But then, like now they're shredding each other on Facebook?
No, I don't think they get along at all.
Oh. No drama there though. What is
no.
this? What are these turquoise shirts?
They're the bocce ones that were a wrong color.
They ordered the wrong color, so now they just wear them for the fun of it?
Well, each of the employees took one, you know. It's like the guy who did it ate it on the thing because he got the color completely wrong.
So that's like not even anywhere close to what...
No, because the new ones you look at, they're like a darker... I actually like the color. It's more of a... almost like that bluish right there a little bit, but a little grayer too.
That's like not bad, but it's like very like teal. Hawaiian luau. Like it's a very bright, like teal greeny type color. Anyway, no drama at the memorial.
No, none at all. I saw one of my aunt Judy dipped out pretty quick, which I was like, "What's up with that?" I didn't see my Uncle Rob.
Like, issues.
Well, my cousin Joey didn't show up, and Joey. Here's some family drama for you guys. Joey, my cousin, was married to Robin, my cousin. They're cousins. And so when they got...
Is that legal?
That's legal if you do it in another state.
Well, because my mom and dad were third cousins twice removed, which is legal.
No, these...
They were like first cousins?
First cousins.
What in the fuck? Do they have kids?
They did.
Do they have like third eyes and
no,
shit?
No, but one of their kids, Joey Jr., he... there's a genetic thing that runs in our family. Uh-huh. And if you're carriers, then you could pass it on, and both of them were carriers. Like, I got tested for this.
What is it?
It's called thalassemia. It's a autoimmune thing.
Oh,
you like, basically, you don't live till about like 3 or 4. You're done by then. And their son, Joey, lived till he was, I think, 19 or 20.
Jesus. So that's considered long then?
Very long, that. Yeah.
And then, you didn't have it? You got tested?
No, I got tested, so I wasn't a carrier, but my son could be a carrier though.
Has he been tested?
I don't think so.
Mm. Well, so, and how old's your son?
28. I mean, if you get married, get tested. You know, if you're going to plan on having kids, get tested. I mean, you should do that anyways. Like, when you go to do your marriage license, you should go and get tests to see if you're predispositioned. Because if two people are carriers for a disease and they don't know it,
right,
you can pass it on to your kid.
So then that would... But then you're thinking, though, that those people then should make an ethical decision and not have children.
It's up to them. I mean... That's up to them. It was right. up to my cousins. It was up to them, you know. And so they ended up getting divorced. And so I think it was a strain on...
Right.
You know, you can't see your aunt mother-in-law or your uncle father-in-law anymore.
It's so crazy, though, that you have their cousins and they got married.
It happens,
that's
dude.
Some, like...
Hey, am I on?
Yeah.
Okay. It happens more than you than you think, probably.
But yeah, but in certain... Like Kentucky or Arkansas...
It doesn't matter. It could happen anywhere. I mean... You just, it could happen anywhere. When people fall in love, they fall in love.
I just think about, like, falling in love with people in my family. It's like, ugh. I don't know. But, you know, at the end of the day, we're all related, bro. We all have some little tiny, like, less than a, like, a super minute, less than a percent connection.
Yeah.
We all came from something.
Yep.
I mean, fucking
aliens.
Salamander that came out of the water and...
No
came
way.
From aliens?
I think humans are genetically modified
by aliens from another planet.
Possibly humanoids, either from
so
another planet or.
So this was like an experiment for them.
Could be. I mean, an experiment gone awry.
No, well, the fact that, you know what, that somebody did you see the Rogan podcast he just did with that comedian Michael Yo?
No, I saw that, but I haven't watched it yet.
Okay, interesting thing. Not, I mean, whatever. Michael Yo is this big, tall dude, half black, half Asian.
So Blasian.
He calls himself Blasian.
Ah, no, that's awesome.
No, but his latest comedy
show
thing that he put out is called Blasian. Well, because Tiger Woods calls himself Coblin Asian. Caucasian, black, Asian, Coblin Asian. He's something else too, though, I think. Anyway.
Rich.
Do your thing, man. So they were talking about it, and Michael Yo goes, did that look good?
That might be my Big Mac right there in his fucking hands. I'm going to get something like that.
That is not a Big Mac. That is a burger from right here, right?
Yeah.
You need that.
Oh, man, that looks delicious.
Have them order you one.
No, I'll... Hey! Come here. Hey!
Hey! He's got all scared. Like,
what is that?
Brisket sandwich.
Let
from Beach Walk?
We need to see it closer.
Get in the camera,
yeah,
dude. That looks fucking delicious.
No, take it right up to it. No, move over in front of the round.
Yeah, oh, man. Beach Walk, guys. They're out
that
front.
Looks amazing.
They're
dude.
Down here sometimes. Oh, that looks delicious, dude. I was going to go get a Big Mac, but I might get that now. I totally might get that now.
Is that shitty enough to fix your hangover?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Dude,
oh my gosh.
Yeah, there you go. There's, yeah.
Oh my Woo. Gosh.
Wait, and what's that place called?
Beach Walk
Barbecue.
Dude.
They're out of Grover, right?
You're going to take a nap after you eat that, bro.
Yeah.
Or a fat shit.
A big group coming in, so I'm gonna
nice.
Scarf it down, bro. Thanks for sharing.
Yeah, that looked good. So yeah,
that smelled amazing.
Oh,
too.
It's just still
it's sauce. So I know it's still like, lingering right here. Yeah. So this Michael Yo goes, oh, because Joe used to be all hung up on like UFOs and all that. And Joe, he's since calmed down. He's like, yeah, I don't know. Like, I totally, it's totally. There's got to be something else out there. All this stuff. Michael's like, nah, like, why would they come here if they're advanced? Like, why would they want to fuck with us? Maybe that's. And then Joe Rogan made a great point. He goes, what if we went to another planet, found like humanoid type activity, but it was basically like from like 1600.
Yeah.
We would be fascinated by that. We would totally go.
Because we're seeing our progression.
Right. So for them, like, why wouldn't aliens be interested? And then Joe Rogan made a great point too. He said, what if, oh, they don't exist. How come people, there's not more documented shit? What if that's just their advanced technology too? Like,
masking.
They can come and hide themselves with whatever. That's the problem with shit is like, 25 years ago, could you have thought of anything like an iPhone 11 Pro in your pocket?
No.
Right. And that's just 25
years ago, yeah.
Just,
no,
that's just 25
no,
years ago, right?
Jesus Christ. I mean, that was...
Well, the first iPhone came out in what? It was 07?
Something. Yeah, it was something like that.
Well, so that's what I mean, though. Like, if you go back far enough, like, back in, like, you know, 1624, do you think they fucking could have thought of a Tesla?
Fuck a lighter. No. A fucking, just a
right.
big lighter
right.
even.
Because they're like,
So, I mean, even the things that we think are super simple, we would have been super advanced to them.
But I think that's the problem with us when you're living in it. You just think that, like, oh, well, like...
Well, that's, I just, I watch a lot of things on YouTube or whatever, documentaries, like, right now with all the... ice melting in Antarctica and stuff
oh,
like
yeah,
that.
Oh, yeah, just saw some.
They're starting to see megalithic structures.
Did you hear about that island they found? Because ice was melting
yeah.
and they found this island. What megalithic
there's like,
structures,
though? Like megalithic, like pyramid
man-made.
Type structures. Man-made. And so it's going to
like
throw...
Like big stone stuff?
Yeah. It's going to throw
wow.
what we thought about how old we are.
Right.
Completely out the fucking window.
It's been doing that, especially in the last 15 years, because what's that place?
I was watching... Randall Carlson last night do his number thing. He's with Graham Hancock.
Graham, yeah,
he's the hippie
yeah.
one who does the. He's like the geologist.
Long hair, the
yeah,
beard.
But he's all about. He's way into numbers and numerology. And
is he
sacred numbers?
I don't know that
but
I
he's
in
like.
That shit, though.
Well,
do
I mean,
you believe in numbers and.
But he's saying what's the universal language.
Mm-hmm.
Is symbols. It's not going to be like language. It's going to be symbols, and you'll go, okay, that
nice
represents da da da. That's a beautiful shirt. I have to get me one of those and be all fucking ripped and shredder today. What's up? Boom, boom, boom. How symbols will be the international or the universal language. But who knows? I mean, there may be symbols or equations out there that we don't even grasp yet.
Why symbols, though, over, like...
Because it had to do with the square space and, like, like triangles and this. And it was crazy because he was talking about how if you keep putting a triangle on itself, it will eventually flatten out. Like, it does this weird...
What do you mean? So, like, if you have like, a triangle, like, here, then you're saying
and it's
put
3D,
a triangle here?
Yeah, and you put it on top of itself like this, and then you add another one like this.
Uh-huh.
And he was saying eventually what it does is it comes down and it just flat... I was like, that's a trippy fucking statement.
What,
but I was pretty drunk too.
What, last night?
Yeah.
Oh,
okay. So I mean, I was like, oh man, I can't.
So you stayed up too late. You drank red wine, and you went down a rabbit hole.
Big rabbit hole.
And that's why you need a Big Mac
or a brisket sandwich.
Yeah.
But they were talking about megalithic structures in Antarctica, and you can look on Google Earth now, and you start seeing these things.
Really?
Yeah.
But that's just like Graham Hancock talked about, because with the use of LIDAR, they're like flying over like in the jungles, the
Amazon. Yeah, and they're finding fools.
Well, there was a place they found down there, and I'm forgetting the name of it now, but like they're finding this stuff by using, so that way they don't have to go in and destroy the forest.
Exactly.
But what's happened is because it was built so long ago and then covered with jungle, it's a fucking trip, dude, what they're finding. And it's like they're constantly finding out that There could have been advanced technological civilizations
for sure.
long ago, and then because of the devastation, it just got obliterated. What do you
yeah.
think? What? Okay, it's my son. Sorry. So it's like a trip, you know, like because even in that one, they found in the Amazon there was advanced use of irrigation.
Yeah,
meaning channeling
yeah.
for the rain and stuff like
yep.
that. Have you heard the one with, and not there's a few of them, but one with Carlson, Graham Hancock, and Rogan.
Yeah, they've done a couple.
It is fucking mind-boggling.
But they said that these structures could be older than Göbekli Tepe. So it's like if they're older, and then they were saying as well, there's a mineral vein that runs through like the Great Lakes that they found in Antarctica, and it's only there. So North America and Antarctica at one time were connected. And I always trip because people go, "Well, you know, tectonic shifting," and I'm like, "Yeah, sure." Some of the tectonic shifting might not have happened in a long period of time that people think. It could have happened rather quickly.
Could have, yeah.
And those are the cataclysms they talk about in the days of old, like the floods and things like that, or fire coming down from the sky, meteorites hitting the earth and stuff like that. And so, I mean, they just attribute it to the gods or whatever.
So the North America thing with so they were once
connected, dude. Like right fucking.
Well, don't they say that all the landmass was all of it, like
Pangaea?
Yeah, and then it all like. You know,
yeah, even in the Bible, it talks about how the land was separated during the days of Peleg, and I'm like, and the word literally means ripped apart, like in the Hebrew.
Wow, dude.
And so it's to me, it's like I think that shit just fucking.
So you think there was like a cataclysm that happened of some nature that could have possibly had all that happen on a much more rapid pace, or correct. You think it was?
I think it was on a rapid pace. Dude.
Really?
Yeah,
can
I
you
think
imagine
it was.
How like. I mean, so anything that was living would have been destroyed. Could you imagine how like
small pockets would have lived? Oh, and that's the thing. And I was explaining this to Lisa. I said we have amnesia because the building blocks that we have now, like if something happens, like our speech becomes the building blocks for communicating for the next people who survived. Like our slang becomes the base words for a new civilization.
Well, it kind of goes into what I think it was Graham Hancock or it was Robert Schock. Did you see the one with Rogan and Robert Schock? Watch that one, dude. That one's fascinating because he's he studied Egypt. Don't go back there anymore. He studied Egypt and all that, and he's saying that a lot of the stuff that happened with the pyramids and all that, there was this mass, like, it was like the amount of water is inconceivable.
Yeah, because they say there's water, like the way it rakes along the Sphinx and stuff, that it was a quickly receding thing.
Like amounts of water that we can't fathom type stuff. But it was the same thing that what Graham Hancock and Carlson talk about is in, you know, like have you heard of the Scablands through like Washington and where there's all these massive boulders in these fields? Where did they come from? Those stones are from further north. But they think what happened was there was these cataclysmic meteorites coming down, hitting, breaking ice apart, melting ice, these massive floods, so like as the ice is melting but flowing down through this massive river, it's leaving these massive boulders, like it's fucking nuts. And like, but everybody thinks like, oh no, it's cool. Like, we have no
look at the mudslides that happened in Montecito 2 years ago. Three years ago. Look at the boulders that were fucking dislodged and put down on the freeway, dude.
And so that's like so minor compared to some
so
of this shit.
Minor compared to what can happen on a grand scale. And it's like people are just like, no, and it's like, fuck that. I'm like, this earth is way more volatile than you think.
Well, and that's just something that is literally happening on earth. We've not lived through something where like you're talking about.
We haven't had an experience where comets or anything have hit our fucking planet.
Think of a rock the size of just this building.
Oh, it would do so much damage, dude.
Slamming into, let's say hypothetically it slammed into the heart of San Francisco.
Done.
Well, like, what
it would displace.
To us, even
well, if it landed in the bay, what if it landed in the bay? Right. I mean, it would send tidal waves over.
Well, how much water would evaporate from the heat first,
and then, be displaced,
and then the amount of water displaced would be like, but that would impact us here because we would have a massive earthquake from that, right?
Dude, and it could trigger other earthquakes.
Right. Well, because now you're because something coming in that fast and that
because that would hit the San Andreas Fault directly on the fucking punchline. Pop.
Right in the balls.
Right in the fucking old hoo hoo.
No, and you know what's sad about like us humans? We just think that we're like badasses and like we have the iPhone and we can record this dumb shit and put it on YouTube and have some cider. But it's like there is shit going on in the ocean, under the surface of the earth, in the atmosphere, in space,
in the hollow earth.
Yeah. Oh God. Are there little midgets that live there?
I don't know, dude.
I can say midgets, right?
No, they would be giants that live there, actually.
Really?
Because of the gravity.
What gravity makes big?
The pressure. Well, you're gonna have to have a denser body mass to withstand the gravity.
So you're saying little people can't be dense? That's kind of rude. That's racist.
Usually you get osteoporosis when you get older, so drink some milk, motherfuckers.
Yeah. Well, raw milk. Don't drink the other shit.
I like raw milk, but you can't find it really anymore.
But other milk is for baby cows.
Yeah.
What flavor cookie do you want?
I don't care.
Peanut butter.
Surprise me.
No penis butter, just peanut butter.
Wait.
What kind of cookie don't I want? I don't want penis butter.
Yeah.
You don't want penis butter. You That's want right. peanut butter.
Damn
you
straight. Want penis butter. That's right. That's right. So funny.
I love having. I should have had more kids.
No.
Just started.
Let's see if he tells his mom.
Oh yeah, I'm sure.
Look at her face furrowing. That's awesome. Oh man. The way her response was.
Well, at first she was just kind of like this, and then she went like. What did she say? Did you tell her that?
Yeah. Yeah, did you get in trouble? You little pervert.
Little brat. That's true. What are you gonna do?
Are you,
are you going?
No, mom needs to finish her.
Oh yeah, oh, she's great. Still got some in there. Right, oh that man, that was good.
Well, because the first reaction, but then she went like this, she went.
Yeah, that was classic.
You know what would be hilarious? Be able to, so, have a side-by-side video screen to where this video was here, and then we had a video shooting that way.
Oh, just to see people,
so
dude.
So they can see what we're looking at.
Oh, exactly. They're like, oh, they're making fun of us. And it's
look
like
at the cattle, they're all cruising.
Wow, that's a big group.
In all the ways.
Oh, I'm going to have to get my fucking heartburn medicine.
What, because of the cider or because of...
All of it.
You're a trooper, though, man.
All of it, dude. I take these ones from Target. It's one a day. Keeps my acid down.
So it's just something you get off the shelf?
Yeah. Because there was some stuff I got that was prescription that was... Yeah. Fucking really good, but it makes me feel also too, some of that stuff feels like there's almost like a weight on my chest a little bit
from the prescription stuff.
Yeah, I think so. So I don't get it right. Just feels like there's kind of a weight right there.
That's kind of, yeah, that would feel uncomfortable to me. I've been really fortunate. I've not dealt with like much heartburn at all.
It sucks.
I know I have friends that, like, I had a friend in high school that used to get it super bad, and it was like, and he like bad enough to where he's just like, I'm good. I'm just going to sit here for a little bit.
You know, sucks. That kind of thing. Yeah, I used to fucking eat. Before I found that stuff, I would eat Rolaids like candy. Well, Tums.
I don't think I've ever eaten a Rolaid.
Or Tums, yeah. Dude. Yeah. Just, and even then, you're like, I got to stop eating them. I'm just fucking chalky inside. I'm going to be shitting fucking, be shitting out a chalkboard.
It's like this multicolored
fucking
piece of
multicolored
chalk.
Log.
Hey, Sam, I don't like you right there. Go. Go out there and be with your mom. She misses you. Hit the road, Jack. Now, go.
Sweet shoes, though, bro.
Vans, they zip on the back.
Oh, those are tight.
Yeah. He's an interesting character.
Yeah, they all are, man. I was talking to these people last night, and...
Are you really drunk yet, or just a little drunk?
No, I was just... No, I was fine. I didn't get like that until I got home.
Oh, okay.
I just had one cider when I got off.
When you got off.
But they were... I don't even want to get into those people.
Really? You brought them up?
Yeah, I'm going to put it down,
What were they talking about?
We were talking about, because they were close to, I don't even remember, we were talking close to my age. So my son's 28, one of their kids is 27, the other was 21, and then they've got an 11-year-old. And so, well, the 20-year-olds are watching the 11-year-old, but he was talking about how his son, he's like, my goddamn son is a fucking, he's a kid, and he's 27 years old. He put dish soap in the fucking dishwasher, and he's all, and he's like, why are you doing that? He's like, he uses dish soap for his clothes. He's like, it's soap, and he's like, ugh.
It's different.
Oh, totally. But he's like, that's my kid. He's like, he's a fucking, ugh. He's a kid, and I'm like, why don't you tell him?
Jesus.
He's like, he gives me, he said, my son gives me grief, like, I'm the ding-dong for going, why are you using that soap? And I was laughing. I was just like, oh my gosh. And I'm like, I am so glad my fucking son knows the difference.
Yeah, but you know, like, we've all been there. Like,
yeah.
I was a kid and did dumb shit.
For sure, but not when you're 27 and you should be on your own.
No, yeah, okay.
When you should be on your own at 27 and fucking...
But at 27 then, is it whose fault is it? Is it, his or the parents?
I'd say both.
I agree.
That's both. You know, because I mean, we were taught how to wash clothes at a young age.
Mm-hmm. I was doing my own laundry starting at like probably 14.
That's about right, dude. That sounds about right.
Yeah.
That's about when we started. Because my mom's like, I don't want to fucking touch your dirty chonies.
Well, or, you know, cum filled
socks.
Yes.
Jizz sock.
Fucking those tube socks, like the ones that were that long. You didn't even need that much length.
No, but you thought about it. You're like, yeah. And Jesus, dude. And I was in my 20s when I found out how if you put a condom on a sock and you roll it and then you put it in a towel, roll it in the towel, it's almost like almost the same feeling as doing
as a vagina?
A little bit.
Really?
You squirt some fucking lube in there.
Remember? Like the inside of the mouth skin is like, you fucking weirdo, dude. No, I never did that, man. You just upped it a notch.
Yeah.
You made your own little, what do they call those things?
It's a fleshlight.
Yeah, you made
it. It was a fucking homemade fleshlight. That's exactly what it was.
Did it?
With a sock and a fucking towel and a condom.
I can't even figure that
out. It's easy cleanup that way, as long as you're not pounding too hard and bust the condom and then you just jizzing all up in the
sock. I'm in my mind trying to MacGyver that all together and it's like, I don't see how that works.
It's pretty easy, dude. So you get your sock.
Yes. Socks first.
Well, you get the sock and then you get your condom, put it in the sock.
In the sock.
In the sock, and then you kind of roll the sock a little bit.
Okay.
So it's kind of, roll it, and once with that rubber, it stretches it out and it looks like a vagina. And then you lay that down on a towel, maybe you fold the towel over, and then you roll the towel, and then it's tight.
I have never, I've heard a lot of men.
I learned that from this one guy that I was buddies with, Jake, when they were.
He told you about this, and then
I was like, I had to try it out. And it worked.
Hey, folks at home, I'm not going
to I don't
this,
need to so. Do it, though, now.
You got one.
Well, I don't need to, because I had condoms all the time, because my ex-wife and I, that was our form of birth control.
Right.
And so I was like, fuck, I got condoms all the time. I'm going to give this a go.
I'm going to give it a go.
Give it a go, and so I did.
Yeah, that shirt is, I'll give you guys $50 for one.
It's a lot, right? Loud.
It is. Fucking
I like
loud.
It, dude.
Come over here and show these people the color.
Drew and I might have to wear them today too.
This is
dude.
The color of the shirt we were talking about. That's wrong.
It's this is the wrong.
And he
color.
Was saying it was supposed to be more like blueish.
It's a, you saw
grayish.
It. It's a darker color. Yeah, I like the.
You
I like.
Know what?
It.
Fuck cops are great sometimes.
Hell yeah,
well,
man.
They're free, especially when they're free.
Exactly.
Hell yeah.
Which is an extra t-shirt. $50. I want one.
Hell yeah.
I'm not gonna pay $50 for that.
No, it's I wouldn't pay $50 for any shirt, dude.
Not even like a. Like a fancy Ralph Lauren.
I'd rather get a Van Housen for 25. Get on over to Kohl's and get that Van Housen.
Van Housen.
And then just if you want, like, you can buy inexpensive shirts like that and just get it fucking tailored. Get it fitted, and then people won't know shit. They're like, damn, that dude looks fresh.
Most of the t-shirts I buy are like somewhere between like $15 and $20.
Oh.
I usually try to get like buy shirts though that are like well, even this sweatshirt, we bought these because it's like something local and it's like promote local shit.
Yeah.
But anyway, what else?
Coronavirus.
Did you hear what I said?
38% I read that and I'm just like 38%.
Oh, you read it too?
Oh, okay, I've read it too. Yeah, 38% of Americans are
And by the way, more than 38%. But what we're talking about is something I saw pastor on Facebook and Twitter, but. Something said that 38% of Americans won't buy Corona beer because they're worried about getting the coronavirus. Fuck you. You're the problem.
It's you gotta educate yourself, people.
You know what?
It's real.
We should have been drinking Coronas right here.
Oh, we should have totally been drinking Coronas, dude.
Oh my god. Yeah, ridiculous. So the first person died last night in Washington State from the coronavirus.
Yep.
And then I just read the headline, I didn't read the article.
It's a county away from where my cousin lives.
Where?
In Washington. My cousin.
Oh, he lives, okay.
Yeah, he's in the military and he's stationed up there. And it's one county away from where him and his wife and kids live and stuff.
So I saw this thing.
Stay safe. Wash your hands.
Granted, yes, exactly. Granted, it's February 20th. It's leap day.
Yeah.
Leap year, leap day, people.
Someone, they happen every 4 years.
Yes.
Someone fucking posted that it's like every... It was some outrageous number and I scratched my head for a second because I'm like, wait, that doesn't sound right.
Was it right or no?
No, it was fucking totally wrong. They were like, it happened. They were like, this only happens. Maybe it was the way
they worked.
Maybe it was the equinox of it or the fucking whatever, but they, right. Oh, they said it happens only once every 100-something years, and I'm like, fuck
fucking God. Idiots. Like, they were probably part of the 38%.
It's probably.
So, back on February 3rd or 4th, I watched a video of, you know who Dr. Drew is, right?
Yeah.
I dig the guy. He's cool. He was on this, some internet show, and they were asking him, like, so what about the coronavirus? What do you think? And you know, like, is it, are we, should we be worried? And he's like, no, here's the problem. The media is fucking full of shit. They're spreading fear. His point,
they're driving dollars by the fear.
100%. And his point was that it, he all these statistics we've all seen about what has killed more people than this, it's another form of like a flu. And if you wash your hands,
and it's not from fucking bats.
It's not from bats. It's not from
coronavirus. That's stupid. If you think that it's somebody got it from eating bats, you're dumb as fuck, because they've been eating bats for centuries over there.
And just because we don't eat bats here in America doesn't mean they suck. It's just that's what they do when they're hungry.
You, yeah.
Dude.
My man Cameron Kearney right there. He last night, he's going to start listening to our...
Who is that dude?
I knew him. Familiar. He's super nice dude. Artist. Hey, buddy.
Oh, yeah.
And... though he was forgot his glasses. Oh. I put them on last night and I was like, no, these aren't me. Cameron worked for me when I had Cisco's, but just a really talented dude. Now he's
you
working...
You say artist, like what kind of artist?
Visual
like
art.
Or like all kinds of shit.
All kinds of stuff. Smart guy. And
like that's his like day-to-day living?
No, his day-to-day living is working with Daniel's Woodland. But oh, all those guys who work there are fucking pretty talented people.
Yeah, I know a dude that works there. I don't know if he's talented. Sorry, Andy. I don't know if you're talented because you work more on the business side of things. I mean, I'm sure you're talented, but whatever.
Last night he was like, I was telling him about the podcast. He's like, really? What is it? And I'm like, Loshel and Matt. And so he's like, I'm check it out. So I was stoked. And then, yeah, I'm super stoked.
Hey, man.
Listen.
It's just like random conversations between two dudes that don't really know what the hell we're talking about.
No. I mean,
some of the shit we do, though.
Some do, we do, but some we don't.
But yeah, the coronavirus thing, man, like fucking wash your hands, and if you're sick, stay home. Don't send your kids to school when they're sick. Like when you're...
But this will, I mean, a lot of this will go undetected because people in the service industry,
right,
don't have insurance and they can't afford to miss work.
That was the other thing I was thinking about the other day. Like when they try to give you these fucking numbers, just like the census in America is not accurate, you guys. Do we have 320 million, 350 million? And then they say, oh, there's this many million or this percentage of the
undocumented
population is Mexican. It's like, there are way more Mexicans here in the U.S. than what they say is here.
Yeah.
And again, I'm great. I love having Mexicans here, but it's not real. Like those numbers they give you. So with the coronavirus, it's way higher. It's way higher.
Oh, yeah.
Because like you said, there's a lot of people that are just going to sit at home. And Dr. Drew's point was the people that are going to die from this are going to have other issues anyway. They're going to have like bad immune systems,
yeah,
elderly, young.
For sure.
But that's how most shit is. So if you're like us, like a normal human, just wash your hands. Don't touch your face.
Wash your hands and punch somebody in the mouth if they go to cough on you.
Yeah.
Just say, what the fuck are you doing?
Go like this first.
And then backhand.
And then backhand.
Pow!
Yeah. That's not even a jiu-jitsu move, but yeah, it's a good one.
That's a Batman move, dude.
Batman move. Kapow.
Kapow, dude. Kapow, bitch.
That fucking old show, like, when they would do that.
It blah!
It's like...
Pow!
When I was a kid, it was amazing, oof, and now I'm like, that is the most ridiculously retarded shit ever.
It's awesome. Adam West. I'm Batman. He was a good Batman.
I'm super bummed that Letterkenny's over.
They're not going to renew it, I thought?
No,
you saw it.
We just were all caught up.
Yeah, I'm still not caught up. I'm slow when I listen to things.
We're watching The Mindhunter. Is that what that's called? He doesn't know because he's asleep by then. I want to see. This show is actually kind of crazy.
I didn't get you...
Penis butter.
Penis butter or peanut butter. I got you chocolate spit.
Mindhunter.
Thank you very much.
American thriller series, and I think it's on Netflix. Thanks,
I'm
bro.
Sure Lisa probably watches that. She's all about those murder, death
it's
kills.
Actually really interesting, and it's like it's
a, that's pretty uncooking.
That's pretty. It's very colorful. It's like it follows these like detectives with the FBI that do like it's like psychological side of things. It's super interesting.
Not there. Nope. See a trash bag in there, dude? There's no trash bag in there. Don't put your dirty fucking shit in there. I gotta pick it up.
I love it when other people talk to my kid. Oh, he already ate all his sandwich. He's back out there. He looks okay. They're all watching Sam. That's a fucking good cookie.
Delicious.
These are all homemade by Negranti, right?
Yep. Melissa makes really good cookies.
Really?
Oh, fuck. She makes amazing chocolate chip cookies.
Oh, chocolate chip.
Whenever she brings them in, she got me some. Like, she got, excuse me, she made some for everybody and for Valentine's and put them in a little bag. It was super cool. Lisa, I got maybe half of one cookie of three cookies. She's like, these cookies are amazing. I'm like, yeah, Melissa made them. She's like, fucking good.
I don't normally eat like sweets and sugars and all that.
Oh man, that's delicious.
A good cookie is a
That's
good
my new one. I'm saying, dude, I'm gonna get everybody starting to say that.
Delicious.
Delicious. That's delicious. Is that racial?
No. No.
Okay.
But nobody's gonna say it but you.
Fuck that. I had other people saying it last night. I'm all delicious, all and they're all delicious. They're like, I like that, and I'm like, right?
It's just because you guys were all drunk, dude.
No. This was before early in my shift.
Then you were all high?
Nope.
Not even high? You rolled in sober.
Did I?
I don't know.
Did I? Or was I laser focused? Laser focused.
You know what's funny? I think you're, in a weird way, more laser focused when you have a little pot in your system.
Me, for sure.
Because you're like chill, but you're like, like, you know what I mean?
When I have Adderall in my system, I'm laser
you do Adderall?
Fucking focused. Yeah, dude.
Fuck, dude, that's what journalists and shit do. That's what our president does.
Yeah, he I sent a meme, like, somebody was talking about how he was just all incoherent.
When? Like, which time?
Oh, damn.
What in the fuck? Those are wigs, right?
Hell's bells. Fucking wastoids. Chicks are lit.
I'm gonna see if I can get it.
Oh, yeah. This is amazing. Oh, boy.
I'm gonna post.
Don't do cocaine in the bathroom.
Right, so I'm gonna post these photos with our video.
You need to, dude.
Oh, there's a dude too.
Oh, Jesus! Stop yelling!
Look, Annie just walked out of the bathroom.
She's what the fuck?
That was kind of his reaction to when he said penis butter.
Oh my gosh.
We were just commenting that when you just came out of the bathroom, right? Yeah, so we saw him come in and you walked out and you were like, what the fuck?
It was all, oh my god, because they came at me like a million miles an hour to all get in the two bathrooms.
Well, that's
he. And I'm like, don't do cocaine in there!
He yelled out really loud and the door's open. Yeah, what? Do you know what it is?
I don't
Cal Poly.
I'm scared, I should have gotten a cider before they came in.
Kids, it's just Cal Poly kids.
If you go get a cider, can you have them make me another one?
Do you see all the people?
No, I get it. But they know you better. There's a gnat in there. Sorry.
I like his hair, dude.
Yeah, thanks for the cookie. That was really good.
Thank you so much.
Which one?
That was the awesome cookies. Oh.
Tell her the new word. Delicious.
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 Yeah, everything's delicious.
It sounds like, oh, that's why you go to places, because it sounds Asian.
No, it sounds like the Grinch.
Oh yeah, you're right. Like, you said it like the way Jim Carrey, the Grinch.
Delicious.
He's like, oh,
delicious. Yeah, Sammy, get a wig, bro. Pull him by the short hairs.
Look, he's like.
Even when I came out, Sammy was like looking at me.
Those people just too. Oh, that is so
funny. Oh. Pervert!
I'm gonna get
fucking pervert!
I'm gonna
pet him! Pet him!
I'll share the photos, guys.
Oh, that's fucking awesome!
So good. There are some good wigs in there, dude.
Oh, I love them.
That dude made a man bun out of his.
Yeah.
Well done, sir.
That guy.
Wow, dude. This. Oh, now Annie's talking to him. Do not put a wig on, Annie. Those people all have head lice. Did you get a text message? Oh, I was going to look at something.
Oh, sick.
What?
Just some news.
Yeah, I was going to see what... Because Trump had a news conference about coronavirus. So I was going to see what was trending. There we go. Trending.
Yeah, I was just told don't say anything on the podcast about this. She's all, keep your fucking big mouth shut.
About what?
Nice try. I love you, baby. I got you covered.
Oh, did you hear that the dude that created Trader Joe's died?
Yeah, Joe Colombone, Colombonio. What's his name?
Colombonio?
It was something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was the one who introduced fucking all the Kaizen and...
Was it him?
Well, he started Trader Joe's.
From the Toyota factory over in Japan.
But he brought it over. But right. Joe, when Trader Joe's first started, I heard
Joe Colombe?
Yeah.
Something like that.
He
89 though, dude. He lived a good life.
He lived a great life. He started a fucking great company.
That is like fucking everywhere. The only thing I'm going to talk shit about this dead fellow about is why is every Trader Joe's have a shitty fucking parking lot?
Gotta keep it real.
Why is that real?
Real stupid.
Well, like, what the fuck is the point of small parking lots for smart cars and the triangle configuration where the lanes are weird angles and it is, they are fucked up. They're loud, too.
That's because they're college students.
Do you really think that's like a Cal Poly bus?
Yeah, totally. 100%.
That's crazy.
100 fucking percent, dude.
That's so crazy.
Because that's the kind of stuff, they'll be like, they're all on the bus, they're having a good time, you see a couple guys took their wigs off because they're like, I'm feeling a little weird. And it's like, don't feel weird, dude, put your wig back on, don't be a bitch.
Enjoy, yeah, no shame.
I mean, you're going to get some pussy if you got that wig on, maybe.
Yeah.
Get some of that college pussy.
I'm telling you right now, though, there's a lot of those girls.
There's some thickies out there.
It's that kind of day.
Zero.
A lot of thickies.
Zero.
Nothing, I'm just one. Saying, go to the gym occasionally, right?
I guess, or lay off the ho-hos.
Or as you said earlier, ding dong.
Yeah, but maybe not. If you maybe ate a little more ding dong as opposed to a fucking ho-ho, maybe you wouldn't be so big.
That is.
I'm not fat shaming anyone. I'm just saying.
Some people think that fat shaming is horrible, and some people think that it's legit, that it can help people. Is it crazy out there, bro?
Beautiful face, dude. Perfect. Yeah, that one chick wanted to pet you.
What did she say to you?
She said, what flavor ice cream
did I
get?
No,
that's code word for like, how big are you?
Yeah, that had to be.
I think she's a future school teacher. Sammy, watch out by the time you're in like junior high, man. She'll be a teacher, like,
do not even go
eyeball on you.
Well, and like Annie coming out of there, out of the bathroom, and her reaction when she comes out. Sam, don't hop, skip, and jump over the wires, buddy.
Yeah, you could pull this all down, and then all of a sudden you're going to get punched in the throat.
The camera's dead. We have to kill you.
Bury you fucking in a vineyard.
Oh, no, just right here.
Just put them in a barrel.
No, like outside the building, right over here.
For sure.
Modelo Creek. You need to change that name to Corona Creek.
Corona Creek.
CV Creek. Oh, she's, she thinks she's all that in a bag of biscuits.
She looks like a bag of biscuits. She looks like a bag of biscuits.
She had a little bag of biscuits.
Bag of biscuits right here.
Is it as obnoxious as it looks?
They're dancing and flailing. One turned around at the bar and was like, oh my God, I have the, I don't know you.
Ah.
I was like, yeah, that's okay.
It's whatever. Okay.
Oh my God, it's so
hilarious.
Crazy.
It's going to be a great
day. All those wigs go really well with those fucked up shirts they did wrong.
Teal for shirts. For sure. I like his wig, though.
They all know Travis, so...
Oh, there we go. They're all Poly students.
Yeah, he was saying that's got to be Cal Poly.
She's cutie.
What? Oh, so by the way, those shirts that... Did Travis tell you those shirts they have on the teal ones, they were incorrect?
No.
The actual shirts over here, they're like a blue or gray or...
That was weird.
Do you have a net, too?
No, it was my... I think I saw my ring. I was tripping.
He's still high.
Whoa, shit. I need to get high.
That'll help too. You need a brisket burger sandwich and
something. Either a Big Mac or a brisket sandwich.
Go with that. That's got to be a little bit healthier than a.
I don't know, dude. That's a secret sauce, man. That's a lot of it. It's a secret sauce.
Oh, you think that's what it is?
The shredded.
You know what that secret sauce is? It's like little redneck semen.
I don't care.
I don't care.
That's good shit.
It's good, dude. Yeah.
Redneck semen is the best for hangovers.
The last time I had McDonald's had to have been...
Yeah, 10 years?
I would say... I kick them out when I'm tired of them. It was probably a breakfast sausage McMuffin with egg.
You know, the egg McMuffin was invented in Santa Barbara.
Really?
Yeah.
By who?
It was actually invented by my uncle's friend for a high school project, and he worked there. He took like a small coffee can or something like that.
Okay.
And he was like, I need to do something. And so he actually came up with it. The son of the owner who owned that McDonald's was like, Dad, just check this out. And he was like, holy shit. And he bought it from him for like
really
hella cheap.
Oh, no.
And then, oh yeah, for sure. And so it was the McDonald's on Milpas Street. Nice.
Nice, dude.
So that's where it started.
Really?
Yeah.
That sucks to look back because you know how much money has been spent on those since then?
A lot.
And he got like nothing for it. He got basically half a bag of dicks for it.
Half a bag of dicks.
Like, that sucks, dude.
Whatever, dude. It's like he was young, he was hyped, he was cool, and it's like in his circle of friends,
nobody
they know
be
he
able to
fucking
retire, dude. Especially looking back,
he
now,
sold it, man. I mean, fucking, he should have. His dad should have fucking been like, you know what? Let's look about this. And his people who were his parents or whoever, they should have been looking out for him.
You know what's better than the McMuffin though? I love the biscuit, like the sausage.
I remember
biscuits.
When the biscuit came
out,
dude.
Oh man,
the biscuit came out in the 80s, dude.
Those biscuits were fucking delicious.
Yeah, they were delicious.
You're not making me. I'm not gonna.
Delicious.
Dude, that yellow hair right here. That's like neon yellow.
That's yellow. That's like fucking.
That's a
Red Bull piss.
Radioactive.
That is radioactive Red Bull piss.
That dude, he's fine. He likes it. Yeah. See, now I'm thinking like McDonald's would be delicious, but I have not eaten that shit in. I probably haven't had it in probably 8 to 10 years.
Good for you.
Yeah. In that time, I haven't had Jack in the Box. I haven't had KFC, Taco Bell.
KFC keeps doing their fucking their donut chicken sandwich again, dude.
Oh, fuck, I saw that. Oh, my God. Why do people think that's even a good idea?
I can get it. I understand where they're coming
from.
But
you think it sounds horrible, though.
I just couldn't fucking.
What would your variation of it be, then? Maybe a different donut? Like, what? Like,
I wouldn't do it with a donut. I mean, it's just too. Ugh.
It sounds horrible to me.
Just feel like fucking dying right now thinking about it. Heart attacking.
Heart attacking. That's horrible to me. I was going to say, any new local stuff on your mind or since we're down in SLO every Sunday, do you know much about what's going on in SLO as far as places to go eat and drink or anything like that?
I don't know dick about San Luis anymore.
Piper gave us some, James Piper gave us some ideas.
Yeah, I don't. In San Luis, I'm.
You don't go down there much, do you?
I don't go down there at all anymore, really.
So, do you primarily just hang out like in Templeton? Is that what you do?
Or yep.
Do you ever dip down into Atascadero or up into Paso?
Once in a while.
You get out of the fucking bubble, bro.
I don't want to get out of my bubble. I like my bubble. I like my bubble a lot, dude. I mean, it's really, it's the funnest place to fucking be.
Your bubble.
Yeah. People, if you come into my bubble, you're gonna have a good fucking time. But I don't. Yeah, if I go out to other people's bubbles,
you fucking burst those bubbles.
Sometimes, but I just am not. I just don't want to deal with people.
So basically, fuck everything except Templeton.
I didn't say that. I just said I stay in my bubble.
What happened?
I need to document something.
Yes.
Being a girl.
Well, you have to be mic'd.
That's right. I'm close. Okay. Being a girl, I've seen and participated in more than one chick going in a bathroom at the same time.
Yes.
Not they're doing cocaine, huh?
No, I don't know. But two chicks came out, two dudes went in.
They're doing cocaine.
I've never seen gay. No, well, I've never seen two dudes go in at the same time.
Oh, I've seen two dudes go in. They're gay, though.
Well, I don't.
Well, how,
well that's
sure?
My only issue is if they're going in there, like dudes are going in there, if they're doing drugs, don't do them on their fucking counters and stuff because kids are in there.
That's like so, my kid that's
a,
in there right now.
Exactly. That's a PSA. If you guys come to Tin City, come and have a great time, but fucking get a little bullet if you're gonna do cocaine so yeah. You don't have to fucking rail it out on the toilet, which is a disgusting. You can get coronavirus up your nose. And then B, fucking, there's kids around here.
Right.
You don't want some little kid
so
fucking touching that shit.
My take on this with the two dudes going in there, they're not doing coke and getting coronavirus through the nose. They're doing dick and butt.
They're doing
and
cock.
Coronavirus in their assholes.
Don't fuck in our bathrooms either. What?
No.
Don't break the sink.
I just created a whole
so
new.
You just took this podcast up to a whole new level.
Okay, bye.
Stop it, people.
Bottom line is, what are bathrooms for, Loesch? You tell them.
A bathroom is a good place. It depends what time of day it is and if you're at work or at home.
Okay, let me... Okay, no, we're talking strictly public bathrooms.
Strictly public bathrooms. No, 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 no. They're just to do your business and get out. If you're in a, if you're at a place, though, that you work and you're comfortable with, catch up on a little news, maybe a little Twitter feed real quick if you're taking a shit. See what's up. But leave it clean.
So shitting, pissing... And I can see even, like, don't blow your nose out here. Go in there, blow your nose, throw the shit in the trash, wash your hands. Right? Like, that kind of shit. That's what it's good for, right?
Yeah.
Why people, and of all the places, too, like, you were just on a bus. Like, do your coke on the bus.
We don't even know if they're doing cocaine, people. That's an assumption. I'm not saying all college students are fucking coke heads.
No, they're
crack whores.
They're probably like our president. They're just going, like, with some Adderall. That's what they're doing.
You know what?
What?
Nothing wrong with a little Adderall once in a while.
Yeah, but you take pills. Do you snort?
Laser focused.
Do you snort it?
No, man. If I snort it, why would I snort fucking Adderall?
That's what I'm saying. Why do people snort it?
Get you high.
Fuck, dude. No way. Yeah, I'm good. The only thing I'm ever gonna fuck, I think that looked like her real hair. No, that's a wig too. Yeah, the only thing I would get ever dip back into is pot.
I love the marijuana.
Yeah, it's delicious.
It's delicious. Sammy.
What's wrong?
Delicious. I like that hat. Where'd you get that hat, dude? Where'd you get that? Because I'm seeing that. I'm seeing that.
Cal Coast Brewing.
Well, I'm seeing that symbol everywhere now, dude.
Yeah, it's from the brewery, that new brewery up there. So, you know how you as a grown-up just asked him a normal question?
Yeah.
And his response was, and then to hit it off, that's a child.
That's fair.
Like, that was his answer, was just hitting his hat off.
Oh, damn, Sam.
Oh, there's a couple more.
Fuck yeah, they went to the beer parlor first.
Sure.
Nice.
Yeah, dude, I like that.
I like all their fucking hair, dude. These three right here are, I like them.
Is that middle one? That looks like it's his hair, too.
It could be his real hair, but like, you're like is
a
that...
surfer?
Yeah, I can't tell.
Yeah, that's
his. Yeah, he got it curled.
Oh, maybe that's not... The other dude's in the way.
The fucking rocker's in the way.
Fuck, dude, I've never seen that many people, other than Halloween, in wigs.
It's amazing.
Yeah, anyway. What do you want to do now?
I'm going to go. I got to do some inventory.
You're going to do inventory and get a Big Mac?
Yeah.
Where's the McDonald's closest to here?
Right there on 46.
Hmm.
2 minutes away.
Perfect for you.
Damn straight. All right,
he's going to go get a Big Mac. I'm going to go drink a little bit more. I'm not very hungry.
33. Join the resistance.
Is there an astrology issue with 33?
It's a number of completion.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, didn't know that. All right, now you know. 33.
Bye.
Join his resistance.
Join my resistance. You guys.